Mike Bloomberg supporters, why? Removed. Without a serious tag, this is going to be a fun thread. I want to read a version of this with a serious tag, but this shit is hilarious. You'd probably have better luck asking this on Facebook. I'm a simple man. I see 37 YouTube ads in a day, and my mind is effectively changed. Edit. Jesus Christ, Reddit. I know what the fuck ad block is. I leave YouTube on in the background on my work computer where I cannot have ad block. I promised at the beginning of the year I would only vote for the candidate whose ads I see most often on YouTube. Bloomberg, Raid 2020. Did somebody say games? I love playing Raid. Shadow Legends. Raid. Shadow Legends is a free-to-play mobile game. I am sorry, I couldn't help but hear you chaps talking about Raid. Shadow Legends. A free-to-play mobile game which I also love. Someone should probably inform the Bloomberg campaign about this thread so they can contract some supporters to come over and post. They already have. In fact, they posted it to find weak points to analyze. This thread is market research, lol. Someone is getting paid to read my shit posts right now and I love it. We should just start dropping Sonic the Hedgehog erotic fanfiction excerpts into the comments. Carrot. Still not voting for Bloomberg. / Edit. I was given an award. So I shall award you all with a Sonic the Hedgehog erotic fanfiction excerpt. Sorry, not sorry. > S Sonic. That's too much. Panic Tales. His voice rising to a shrill tempo like a cymbal struck too many times by a child careless of the sound it makes or the rhythm of proper instrumentation. > Gotta go fast, roared Sonic as he upped the momentum as your today's activities were no friend to Newton's third law of motion. > From the bushes, Abraham Lincoln watched, and when he realized the growing need within his own heart, he knew that the future was a strange, an exciting place indeed, because the 1 minute long ads keep telling me keep telling me I always get sad when I see someone stroke out right in front of me on Reddit. Because he offered me $250. But Young offered you $1,000, month, asterisk every month. ! But he dropped out, so I lowered my asking price. Most of the Bloomberg supporters I know are 1. Former Republicans, independents who despise Donald Trump. 2. Democrats who despise Bernie. 3. Democrats who have resigned themselves to thinking he'll win the nomination. Because that's how the world works now. And he's better than Trump. My social group is entirely comprised of white college-educated urban professionals in their 30s. So to put it politely, the racial issues surrounding Bloomberg aren't really a concern for the monsieur, not me, but my aunt and uncle. Basically, after she was done explaining that they hide their incomes, which are very high, so as to avoid paying the actual amount of taxes they should, etc., she told me he was gonna be their guy. Because that funniest part was I had just finished saying I basically paid a lot of money for health insurance and in taxes because I freelance. And she somehow thought that me, a poor person, actually paying my taxes was absurd and I should somehow agree with and like be proud of their cunning. My family hates the monsieur. Yeah, no, you could alert the IRS of their tax evasion scheme. Plus, you can get 15% to 30% of the taxes collected as a reward if you report tax fraud. Only in cases of large-scale fraud where actionable evidence is provided. Not just random tips. Because as Americans, what we really want in an election is a former Democrat running as a Republican against a former Republican running as a Democrat. Both as arrogant as can be, but claiming to concerned about the little guy, both with baggage that should sink any presidential hopeful. Such a time to be an American. Remember when people said Romney was too rich to be a good president? They also said Romney wasn't a good person because he was mean in high school. Boy, we got what we deserved on the rudeness front. He's the lesser of two evils. I'm looking forward to Bezos 2024, where he just skips the charade and outright buys America. I'm paid to make memes. Bloomberg Associate. Alright, so you, beavers and buttholes, what are your qualifications? Beavers and buttholes. I have 6,676 karma. Bloomberg Associate. Fuck, he's good. You're hired. Edit. Karma count. Wait, does karma count matter? I'd like to cash in, please. You've got a long way to go. I heard once you get 500k, you can cash in for a Snoo-themed toaster. Not defending his perspective, but I think I can offer at least some insight into the mind of one Bloomberg supporter I know. My dad, through the mid-2000s or so, identified as a Republican, but he was definitely on the more moderate side of that spectrum. Conservative about economics, but anti-war, pro-environmental protections, and a leave people alone mentality on social issues. He doesn't like talking about politics, but he pays attention. He didn't like it when politicians lied or made outrageous claims, but would respect one if they seemed forthright, honest, and didn't treat them like an idiot. He doesn't really pay a lot of attention to political gamesmanship. So things like whether Bloomberg bought his way into the party doesn't really matter to High Monsieur. He voted for McCain in 2008, but Obama in 2012. It was during Obama's administration that he really started to sour on the Republican Party. The more blatantly inaccurate GOP claims became, the more personally insulted he felt. Trump seemed like the culmination of everything he didn't like about the party going into 2016. And so, he switched his party affiliation to Dem for the 2016 election and voted Clinton. So now you have a man who feels abandoned by the party that used to represent his center-right views in the Democratic Party. And here comes a candidate that seems straight out of that party he used to identify with. For people like my dad, Bloomberg is the sort of person he'd always have voted for. That isn't to say he'd only vote for Bloomberg. He's essentially in the anyone but Trump camp. But if you were to poll him, he'd pick Bloomberg. I don't know how much of his support comes from people that felt abandoned by the GOP. But from my soul, anecdotal example, I can at least kind of see it. Greater than, leave people alone, mentality on social issues. The guy who's working to ban large sodas and guns gets this vote. Haven't you heard of Bloomberg's most famous policy, stop and leave people alone? Stop. Minorities. And leave. White. People alone. Edit. I can't tell for sure, but are people thinking I meant this like it was a good thing? Stop and frisk was a bad policy that violated the Fourth Amendment, and that's before getting to the racism apparent in its selective enforcement. Even his position on gun control comes from he views us all as the proletariat and doesn't like the idea of the lower classes being able to overthrow oppressors. You pretty much described my dad. Lifelong Republican. Left the party when Sarah Palin arrived on the scene. Moderate Democrat now. Loves Bloomberg because he sees Bloomberg as a pragmatic guy. Also, he sees the difference in NYC between Bloomberg and de Blasio, and sees this as a litmus test as to why we need to avoid politicians like de Blasio. This election, we may have a New York billionaire business mogul in his 70s, who has enacted racist policies, made sexist comments, and switched political parties for convenience, versus Donald Trump. So when the Dems run Bloomberg and lose, do they forfeit the right to oppose racist, sexist, democracy-corrupting billionaires? I'd say they forfeit the right to be a respectable political party. This is the United States of America. We don't do respectable political parties, because I want to be stopped and frisked. I hope you're a minority then. He called out Trump by saying he had an ugly spray-on tan, was obese, and had fake hair. I am 12, by the way. Turns out in the alternate universe, US is just a big elementary school playground. I was one of the only people on this site to be supporting Bloomie since November. It's easy to get sucked into quotes and attack ads. But I lived in NYC for a majority of Bloomberg's 3 terms. In addition to Giuliani's and de Blasio's. And it's ridiculous how much more effective, less corrupt, data-driven, efficient, etc. Bloomberg's administration was. Economy prospered, despite 9/11 and financial crisis. Crime plummeted. Public health drastically increased. He doesn't get enough positive press for leading anti-smoking initiatives in the early aughts. Government actually worked effectively and on budget, etc. It's sad because I feel like a large portion of this sub hates a caricature of Bloomberg that the Sanders campaign has created. I'm a neoliberal and he's the perfect candidate. He believes in capitalism, but not unconstrained capitalism and will reduce wealth inequality. Believes in free trade and open borders. Has led the fight on gun control and global warming. An actual effective plan. Green New Deal is ridiculous if you actually look at it. I also think he will be most effective at defeating Trump. His advertising and campaign apparatus is orders of magnitude more effective and well-run than competitors. He takes away Trump's biggest advantage. Bloomberg is an actual billionaire and did it without a loan from dad. And is wildly acceptable to moderates. He got a lot of shit, rightfully, for stop and frisk. But I think the nuance here was missed. He was asked to implement it by leaders of these black communities. The victims of all the violence were other black people. Homicide and violent crimes drastically decreased in these communities. It went too far, and went on for too long. But I feel like he's been typecasted as a guy just mass arresting minorities. Also, I feel like this whole thing is white college students virtue signaling. Bloomberg currently has more black support than Sanders. Familiar with sexual harassment claims this site wildly misreports this as being personally against him, when they were against his campaign. Look, every large company has dozens of sexual discrimination lawsuits. Hell, I worked in M&A and most 100 to 200 person companies had 3 to 4 lawsuits. But yes, if you're socialist or a leftist, obviously he's not your candidate. Anyways, even if you disagree with me, I hope you at least engage, don't downvote, since every single upvoted post right now is anti-Bloomberg, which is the exact opposite of the question prompt. And I think it's important this sub understand why Bloomberg is currently running second in polling. Blaming it on advertising and astroturfing really misses the real reasons people support him. E.g., they want moderate who is effective at governing who can defeat Trump. I live in NYC too. Bloomberg's policies are why my friends routinely were molested by police. Why one of them had an NYPD officer draw a gun on him outside his own apartment building. Why they refused to drive in the city for fear of getting pulled over. And before you say anything, no, they never deserved any of it. One is an English teacher. Another is an attorney. Boy, did the officer freak the fuck out when he discovered that my buddy was clerking for a well-known judge at the time. Another was in college at the time. Oh yes, all were black. Yeah, his mayoralty worked out great for me and my family. We're white. My friends? They aren't. I'll vote for Bloomberg over Trump should he be the nominee. But I'll need to get drunk and preemptively apologize to my friends first. I'm glad to see this response. It gets so annoying to me see posts like, well, he worked out well for me 'cause I'm a white guy. Posts. The total lack of empathy for other citizens' rights, it's disturbing. Thank you for watching.